Let's welcome Mr. Gaurav Gupta from DuPont Photovoltaic Solutions, Mr. Naushad Saifi, Senior Director Sales from Jinko Solar, Mr. Vineet Tyagi, Head Sales and Marketing from Insulation Energy, Mr. Nikhil Gupta, ZSM North, Sales and Marketing, Satvik Group, Mr. DK Jha, General Manager, Hanwha Q Cells, Mr. Siddharth Sen Gupta from Semcorp, Mr. Gautam Samanta from Orange Greenco as our session chair and moderator, Dr. Devajit Sarangi. We are happy to have Mr. Gautam Samanta as our session chair and moderator for this session.
Yeah, thank you, Anand. I think thank EQ International for giving us an opportunity to talk, you know. But you have rightly pointed out, you know, the solar cell or module has got a different material, you know. So as on date, silicon is very, very popular. The reason why silicon is so popular, the reason is that, number one, silicon in the earth is the second abundant element, which is an 18.5% is the material is present. There are other technologies like the cadmium telluride, then CIGS, and also there are several other material like gallium arsenide and all, you know. But you have to look the material availability and the cost. Schoeffer, from 1954 onwards, basically the AT&T lab, and which are earlier, you know, the in the US, they have done a lot of research, particularly for space material, you know, which is the better suited material, which is generating more efficiency on that, you know. If you look into the today, the ground mounted, the solar cells, mostly coming basically from silicon in the value chain, like sand, silicon dioxide. From there, it gets a metallurgical grade silicon, and it's purified, making a polysilicon ingot. And after that, it is melt and prepared a ingot, and then wafer slicing, then cell, then your module. But in the module, there are different material attached to it, because cell, in general, cannot sustain in the weather for a long term, you know. This solar cell is nothing but is a diode, a big diode. So if you look into the evolutions in this technology, basically when we have started, say in 94s, you know, and a couple of my colleagues are also here, you know. So those days, the silicon was coming from the semiconductor off-grid silicon, which has melt and which used to be produced for the solar cells, right? But today, from 2004 and 5 onwards, we have got a very dedicated solar cell silicons, you know. These silicons are 6N impurities. It's not as pure like 9N impurities in a semiconductor industry. So therefore, see, if you look into the whole industry in the value chain, which has been evolved from 25 to another 14 or 15 years, you know, and all the manufacturings and everything, you know, even India we have started, but the volume wise, why China has gone into the such a big volume and dominating the world, you know, today. So, ladies and gentlemen, I will try to introduce, you know, my panel panelist first, you know. Nikhil, can you talk something about your company and your profile and how your company is doing the different product on solar photovoltaic module?
Thank you, Gautam sir. My name is Nikhil Gupta. I am from Satvik Green Energy Private Limited. It's the Ambala based company. It's a we are a module manufacturing company. We have also increased our capacity also. Now we are shifted to 500 megawatt company. The now this is the and we have all the certificate regarding ICs, BIS, and also BI monopark and polypark also. We have certificate within a week also. So the and we have manufacturing now poly crystalline, mono crystalline, and now we are soon moving out of monopark also. So that's it. We are basically working in the North India, most of the, because we are very nearby in India, and most of the company, big company, we are supplying so very good quantity, and that's why we are increasing the 200 megawatt, the net just doubled in the 500 megawatt.
Yeah. Thank you. Next is Gaurav. You can introduce yourself and your company.
Myself, Gaurav from Navitas Green Solutions. We are Surat-based manufacturing company. and it's a current operation capacity of company 200 megawatt. And recently, cells, main component as we described, and efficiency, it's a major challenge. So currently, in market that we are producing 330 watt peak, it's generally 19 plus, it's a cell efficiency. So currently, we look market for the capex and resco, and most probably to the solar cells as we are doing the resco project for the maximum generation of the unit and waste power project. And recently we are doing project in Delhi for Tihar Jail and other CBS college and other schools in under the Delhi IPGCL projects.
Thank you, thank you. On my right side is DK Jha. So he is from Hanwha, and today Hanwha, I think more than $65 billion company, and partly on the solar cell. So they are a vertically integrated company and very in-depth research on each and every product, you know. So I'm fortunate enough to audit their factory for 3 days, you know, and I'm so happy that he's here, you know.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm part of Hanwha Group. Hanwha is one of the leading conglomerates from Republic of Korea. Today in solar, we have a capacity of 10 plus gigawatt. Factory is located at four centers, China, Malaysia, Korea, and US. US plant was just inaugurated beginning of this year. When we talk about the solar developments, technologies, the emerging things in solar, there are a lot of things happening because we had acquired Qcells of Germany, which was a technology leader in field of solar. And still we are keeping the technology field in Germany. Thalheim is the major center. All our plants are VD certified labs located in each of the plant. Unfortunately for Indian supplies, now it is the regime of BIS in India. Therefore, though we are sitting here to discuss in the panel about the emerging technologies to be, and of course it should be relating to the supplies coming to India, we all have to discuss on how the changes in technologies which are emerging in solar. Every quarter there is something new coming up. However, now with BIS regime in place, where the time taken to register a product is taking 4 to 6 months. So which way things are going to be coordinated in terms of sales to India or bringing the produce to India has to be seen. I think Dr. Samantha should play a bigger role on behalf of this industry to coordinate and spend some time with the MNRE guys, with some changes happening in the government level also now, lateral entry of the people in the MNRE also. There are professionals who have entered now.
Yes.
And so I think if the industry makes a joint effort with the gentlemen entering the MNRE, things could change and we could see the emergence and adoption of the new technologies or offers of new technology to this market in a better way.
Right. Thank you, DK. Talking about the BIS, you know, so BIS is nothing but it is a toll gate entry for Indian PV industries, you know. So IEC is actually truly, you know, all the test which is done rigorously, you know, like thermal cycling, damp heat, humidity, freeze. And apart from that, there is another test which is called safety test, you know. So all these things and from the Indian condition, still not, it is framed, you know. So it needs to be taken into account. We'll go into the quality, particularly on the PID, you know, where as per the IEC, 60 degrees Celsius and 85% humidity and for 96 hours. But in Indian location, if you install any module, particularly in any desert area, where average temperature is 45 to 50 degrees Celsius and the cell temperature is trapped inside plus 25 degrees Celsius. So therefore, the 70 degrees Celsius is the operating. So what we are testing for PID is not the correct thing. So certain things, you know, we have to be bit careful in our quality standards. You know, we will look into that. On my left is Naushad, and he's representing a company which is last 6 years is the number one in the world. You know, I mean, he's representing Jinko, and talked about something about Jinko.
So, hi everyone. First of all, I like to tell you about my feeling. So, Samantha sir may have forgotten, but I remember it.
In my workshop, you know.
So, yeah, during my engineering days, so I have done my industrial training under Samantha sir, and he is the one who has given me the flavor, first flavor of the solar. He used to teach me the periodic table and the process of the solar in 2002. So after 19 years, sharing the stage with Samantha sir is like a, it's like a immense pleasure for me. And he's the one who actually introduced me to solar. And we spent some time in Mozubair also together. And, but this is the first time I'm sharing stage with Dr. Samantha. And earlier I was not knowing this, that he'll be the part of this panel. So this is a good surprise and a very, very motivating factor for me. So
thank you. Talk about your product, future product of.
So yes, as you said, Jinko is continuously, consecutively number one in the Bloomberg list, and the capacity wise and the shipment wise, we are doing pretty well in last few years. And last year our shipment was around 11.44 gigawatt globally in 2018, and this year we will be targeting around 15 gigawatt in 2019. And we are, as others big players, all are working on the new technologies like monopuck, bifacial, half cut. We are also working on the same lines to be in the market. And the change has to be there. And it is actually continuous from inception of the industry. But actually now we are feeling this change because the market is too big. Earlier markets were not at that size. That's why we were not actually feeling the change. But change was every time. And it's actually from the inception of the industry. So this why this change happening? The important question is this: from last few quarters, you must be the question must be pinching in your mind that why now every big company is talking about the monopuck and bifacial? Why people are saying that poly is phasing out? So why it is so? What happened suddenly? So. Answer is that there will be a win-win. This is a win-win situation for both, for the manufacturer, from the developer, both side. If you see, so from the manufacturer perspective, if you see, for example, if you take if I have a one laminator having a carrying capacity of four modules at a time, and I produce a monopark with 400 watt module, then I'm going to produce 1600 watts. In a single cycle, and if we go for 335 of poly, then it will be around 1250 or 1300 something. So there will be a gap of 250 watt if we switch the technology. So that 250 is around 20% raise in the capacity. So if we go for a monopuck or bifacial or better technology, then my plant, if I am a 10 gigawatt company, then my yearly output will increase by another 2 gigawatt. So that means another 2 gigawatt revenue, extra revenue for me. So for manufacturer perspective, this is the major reason why people are actually the big companies are actually switching to the better technologies.
I think we'll talk more on the
okay.
later stage.
Okay,
you know.
Please.
So on my left is Siddharth Sengupta. He is representing Sembcorp, one of the big corporate in Singapore, and fortunately, we have had a journey in photovoltaic in 1994, 1st of February onwards, you know, on the same side, and we went to Italy those days. So talk something, Siddharth, about your journey in photovoltaic.
Thank you. Actually, we started our solar career together. In 1994, I was a part of manufacturing of solar module. Mr. Samantha was, in charge of solar cell. So I learned a lot of techniques from him and a lot of technology. From him, when we started our career, you know, the solar cell was round and 35 watt was the panel wattage. From there, now we are talking about 400 watt module, you know, single module.
Monofacial.
So monofacial, yeah. So even monofacial, yeah. So we have already, you know, made a long journey from circular cell to pseudo square to perfect square, and then mono, then poly, again park mono. So that's a lot of changes happened. Yeah. Probably I am the only person representing the IPP here. I am representing Sembcorp Green Infra, which is a part of Sembcorp Industries Singapore. In India, we have 1.7 gigawatt of assets, mostly wind. Now we are, aggressively looking for solar assets, to add solar asset to make it, balancing in the portfolio. Apart from that, we have 2.6 gigawatt thermal power plant in Nellore. In Singapore, we are the largest IPP in solar. We have around 200 megawatt plus solar assets in Singapore. Singapore 200 megawatt is also very big, because Singapore is a very small country and mostly rooftop. The project will be implemented after 18 months. So there we have to think about the forward technology. Today, polycrystalline is the majority market share in India, but elsewhere it is slowly coming down. I think monopoly will be 60-40. But this scenario is very soon changing. I think next year will be 50-50, and now onwards mono will take over. And then, the bifacial technology also will be streamlined in next 2 years. India is always 1 year behind the global market because of various reasons, because of land and cheaper. We always calculate LCOE. So I'd like to touch upon some of the points, Gautamda. LCOE part, and another thing also, when I'm interacting, apart from the top five in the tier one, like Jinko, Jay, Longi, and there are a few others, they have all the certifications. See, when we work on the technology side, when I work my LCOE, I always see the module related losses in my
PVC. We will talk more on the system design side also.
That's a very important task. And when I ask the third party validated certificate, I only get from few of them, like Jinko and other. But most of them, guys, they do not have, but it costs money.
Right.
So they bypass that. So I want to touch upon that point with you.
True. Thank you very much.
Now, going to Sarangi.
Next is Dr. Devojyoti Sarangi. He's from IIT BHU. And after that, he did his PhD from NPL. After that, he was in Switzerland for a while, and then he came back and joined me in Mozambique in R&D. After that, he was in Siri Singapore R&D almost 6 years. He was also heading the quality in Bikram, and now he started his own venture, and also particularly in the module quality, he's representing a German company. Can you tell me something about your journey?
Yeah, thank you, Gautamda, just introducing me here. Yeah, I am Dr. Devojyoti Sarangi. It's a long journey to meet the solar. I was with Gautam Samanto, Nongsad, and Mozerbeer. I was also with the Siddharth at Bikram Solar. I was the R&D head at that. Also, I spent 6 years at Solar Energy Research Institute of Singapore. Now, at this moment, I am the independent consulting, but trying to consult the two different company with the main company, which the aim is completely different. One company is called the Borealis. Borealis is the polyolefin manufacturer. They come up with a different kind of solution. It's called the encapsulant, polyolefin film based encapsulant. If you really go to the module technology, the EVA is one of them, which is really integrating the solar cells between the glass and the back seat. Now, why EVA? There are a lot of kind of questions. Now, if we really replace the EVA with some other kind of materials that is called the polyolefin, you can really solve a lot of other issues like the degradations ones. The Borealis having planned to construct a module that is called, I call it the super modules, where the module cannot degrade, like the module degradations can be 0.7 to 0.2%, which is again the Snellen free and PID free. Apart from that, you can have a module which is completely recyclable in that case, and end of the lifetime, you can try to remove the glass out of the modules. So this is they have a plan, and they come up with the thermoplastic polyolefins, the different kind of technology. So hope we can introduce these kind of materials into the Indian market. Couple of module manufacturers already tried, and they're doing it. That is one. I'm also representing one company that is called the PI China, that is a part of PI Berlin in China. Like when you buy the modules, like they are the module manufacturer, we ensure that the module manufacturer really obey, like they follow the basic, the bill of materials that we have agreed upon with that. So that's why there is a third party always present there during the manufacturer. So they really ensure that what are the production is going on the right. So the PI China is doing it in China. And also when you're making the module, how to really ensure that the module power, you're buying 330 watt module is really exactly 330 watt. It's not really the 325 watt. So you send to the third party laboratory to retest it. So these kind of things I'm representing to them. And doing some other small activity that can become, I will touch upon that. But basically, I'm trying to solarize the world, I try to give a little bit of more flavor into the solar, and trying to giving the message is that solar is really sustainable. Yeah, don't really stick to the price, stick to the quality, and you will really win.
Okay, thank you. Next is Binit. He is representing Insolation Energy in Jaipur. I think if you are entering Jaipur on the left hand side, you will see his factory.
Good evening, everybody. First of all, I must find out that I am the odd one, maybe on the right side, because all of them are having the almost some kind of lineage, same lineage, colleague relationship, or maybe. So, once again, very good evening to all of you. My name is Vineet Tyagi. And I head sales and marketing in Insolation Energy. Insolation Energy basically is a module manufacturer. We have a fully automatic line at Jaipur, as sir just mentioned. We have a capacity of 100 megawatt. Our journey with solar started around 2 years back. But before that, we had around 5 megawatt of plants, one in Ujjain and another one at Bikaner. That is as an IPP. And as a group, we are a part of Fluidcon engineers, which are mainly into real estate, lifestyle businesses, and in hardware businesses. So for solar per se in manufacturing, we are 2 years old. But going by the responses, I would say in the last 2 years, we have almost doubled our capacity from 60 to around 100 right now. And we are having facilities for both multi, mono, as well as the monopacks. And primarily, we are having around five bus bar we are currently into.